Today on Up Front, some frightening scenes in the Northwoods. Mass protesters and heavily armed guards at the mining site near Mellon. Can this situation be defused and how? The president delays a key part of his health care overhaul. I'll be asking Milwaukee Democratic Congresswoman Gwen Moore the key question. Is Obamacare in trouble? And why did she say that Governor Walker will never be president?
Covering the issues important to Wisconsin. This is Up Front with Mike Boucher.
Do not take my family!
Get out of our home! Get out of our home!
Mass protesters confronting mine workers at a drill site near Mellon. Armed security guards from Arizona dressed in camouflage carrying assault rifles in the Northwoods. Today on Up Front, defusing the situation before someone gets hurt. Hello again, everyone. I'm Mike Boucher. The controversy over plans for a large new iron ore mine in Wisconsin reached new heights last week. The company, Gogebic Taconite, GTAC, is doing exploratory drilling in the Pinoki Range in Ashland and Iron counties. But on June 11th, these protesters, their critics call them eco-terrorists, overran the test site, swearing at and threatening GTAC employees, taking a cell phone and damaging some equipment. In response, GTAC quietly brought in a heavily armed security firm from Arizona, but last week temporarily suspended its use after licensing questions were raised. So what happens next with the GTAC mining project? We're asking Republican State Representative Mark Honadel of South Milwaukee, a supporter of mining, and Democratic Senator Bob Jauch of Poplar, whose district includes the mine. He's at our Duluth sister station, WDIO-TV. Gentlemen, thanks to both of you for being with us. I'll ask you the same question, and if you can be brief in your response. The question is this: just how volatile is this situation? Senator Jauch, it's in your neck of the woods. We'll begin with you.
I think it's really important to note that that group of hooligans a month ago who went out to that site can't speak the English language. One of them is going to be charged on Monday through the proper law enforcement process. I don't represent the people of northern Wisconsin. And for 30 days since, there has been peace. The company did not hire this military-style force until July 4th. There was no necessity. It's excessive. There's no one objecting to a Wisconsin, hopefully Wisconsin-based security presence, could be armed security to protect property, and along with citizens in the north, they're working very hard to promote education and protection of the resource, not confrontation.
Representative Honadel, how volatile is that situation? Is the danger period over?
Well, thanks for having me, Mike. I think that the danger period should be over, number one. In this entire situation, everybody has to take a breath. I believe the senator would agree with me on that. However, when it all started, when people's personal property gets destroyed and vandalized, something has to happen. You know, I do not fault GTAC for hiring some sort of security company at all.
You know, you don't think it was an overreaction?
I do not, because personal property and freedom are the two things we cherish most in this country. And if somebody's going to wreck it or vandalize it, you do have the right to protect it. Now, one thing we don't need is we don't need volatile letters from senators and representatives accentuating the problem up north.
For 30 days, they had a dignified security presence up there. They didn't need to bring in this military force that looks better suited for a Venezuela jungle than the forest of northern Wisconsin. There was security force. People were respecting it. The fact that they brought them in really did heighten tensions. They were legally operating. I hope they don't call them back. My understanding is they've hired a new security firm. My understanding is they're from Wisconsin. I don't think they're going to be a military-style force that actually sneaks through the woods looking for citizens as though they're the enemy. It's private property, but it's public access. And so people have a right to be up there. We have to commit to a dignified security presence that protects the workers and property as it has been for the last 30 days without a military-style presence, but still allow people to go out and enjoy the beauty of the Pinokis.
Representative Honadel, right. Back in June, you talked about a need that you saw to restrict public access to some of this land as this testing was being done. Does that need to be revisited, in your opinion?
I think so, and I think Senator Jauch and I agree on one main thing here. Everybody needs to take a breath and let this process flow the way it's meant to be. The legislation is passed. Okay, it went through two sessions of the legislature. It is law now, and We have the ability to iron mine. And it should just continue to move forward. What I continue to point out to Wisconsin citizens is that this is just the permitting process. It's not even definite that they're going to mine here yet. They have to go through the fall exploration. And I don't know. The whole issue is out of control.
Access should be restricted, to the public access?
Yes. And we spoke about that a little bit earlier. In the same regard as the logging industry on managed forest lands, they have a perimeter that has to be respected. It has to be, it's a work zone. We don't want anybody to get hurt, whether it's a worker or a citizen. So maybe we should have the same type of deal that the logging industry has for the mining industry. I don't know how the senator thinks about that, but we should talk.
I don't have a problem with that. Let me go back and reemphasize one point. For 30 days with a dignified security force, there were no incidences of violence. It was peaceful. No one was breaking the law. There was no need to bring in this military-style force and put them into the situation. It was an insult to the people of northern Wisconsin. It was excessive. What we can do is look at ways of establishing a perimeter. In this case, it's a 50-foot perimeter, and it's perfectly sufficient. Now, if this company gets its bulk sampling approval or the permit sometime this fall or later this fall, that involves five sites in which explosives are going to be used. I think that we need to come up with some kind of a reasonable protection zone for the purposes of protecting the safety of the public and protecting property, but it's got to be very carefully prescribed so that you're not limiting the public's access to the Pinocchio Mountains. It's also important to note that drilling should stop in the next 2 or 3 days. They're on 8 of 8 drill sites. There's really no need for security for the next few days, weeks, and we really then ought to sit down and do what's best. Don't bring back this military kind of force that really horrified people right when they saw those images. It isn't necessary. And let the public enjoy the Pinokis, experience the Pinokis, and protect property.
Anything you want to add to that? Or you kind of feel that time to move forward?
It is definitely time. And a lot of the issues I agree with the senator on. Let's just get this process going. These are good Wisconsin jobs. We can mine here safely and environmentally friendly. Let's just get it done.
I'm gonna pause right now. I want to take a break because I want to come back and follow up on a point you made, Representative, in just a moment. We're going to talk about whether there's anything that could still scuttle the mine project. We'll be right back on Upfront in a moment.
Upfront with Mike Gouche, brought to you by American Transmission Company,